George Pell will lie in state at the Vatican on Friday after his death yesterday, aged 81. He suffered a cardiac arrest after a hip replacement surgery in Rome. Overnight, Pope Francis paid his tribute to George Pell in a statement saying, "This faithful servant who followed his Lord with perseverance, even in the hour of trial, may be received into the joy of heaven and receive the reward of eternal peace." Father Tony Percy is the General of Archdiocese in Canberra and Goulburn. He was a friend to George Pell and he joins us live now. Father Tony Percy, thank you for joining us. Can you share with us the details about your friendship with George Pell and the impact that he had on your life?
Yeah, certainly. Thanks, Gabriella. I didn't know George Pell, in fact, until about 2008. So I'm a priest here in Canberra and he was living in Sydney and Melbourne, obviously, but he asked me to head up the place where we train all the future priests in Sydney. So that was a big surprise to me. And so I got to know George very well. My first meeting with him was in his office in Sydney. And I asked him, was I the second or third pick? He said, about the ninth. He loved the banter. And so then that ensured then a great friendship and a very good working relationship for quite some time, and then it continued after I finished out of that job in 2015. So, yes, I got to know him very, very well.
So he had a great sense of humour.
Oh, he did. Yes, he did. He loved banter and loved quipping, and he was very entertaining and very thoughtful at times, very compassionate as well. Very generous, actually, to people in need. You know, people would come to him for personal needs because they were struggling in their families and stuff, and George, out of his own resources, would be very generous to them. He was that sort of guy, yeah.
Is that how you remember him, by being a generous, funny person? And do you think that's how many of his supporters will remember him?
Yeah, well, everyone has their own, you know, different accounts of people. I get to know people in different ways. Certainly the circle that I move in, you know, you get people that are critical of George because I'm a Catholic priest and the church is a very wide church, and other people that are very complimentary. So, I mean, that's normal with anybody, I suppose, but particularly with public figures, and prime ministers probably share the same sort of thing. And no, I think that's how I'll remember him. I mean, George was a tremendous man of faith. One of the last times I met him was in jail just before the High Court decision. And I went with Kevin Andrews, who was a Liberal MP, as you may well know, and we went there thinking, okay, what some of the areas we might try and get this conversation sort of keep it going if he was sort of depressed or something. But he was really on top of things and very entertaining. In fact, he launched into a 20-minute tirade against the Vatican finances. It was hilarious. I was looking in the cell for cameras and microphones to see who he wanted to hear this. And so it was an hour and about 10 minutes of extraordinary encounter with George. He was, if you'd say that Queen Elizabeth was sort of known for her dedication to duty, then you'd have to say that George was a magnificently stoic guy, I would have to say, yeah. So,
how significant was his contribution to the church? And can you even speak about the significance about the church behind you?
Oh, yes, the church behind me. George was a big supporter. I went to George. This is the old cathedral in Goulburn, and it's the only greenstone building of its type in the world. And it's magnificent. The rock that you see there, Gabriella, is 440 million years old. So I invite people to come down here to have a pilgrimage. It's a beautiful, as I said, it's the only greenstone church in the world. And we've just restored it to the tune of about $9 million. We've got a bit of debt, so all the more reason to come and visit and get the shakes when you hit the tap and go. But George was a very very big supporter, actually, of arts. George always thought that bishops should be very thoughtful with the way they promote art in the church and beauty in the church. That's one of his legacies, I think. One of his legacies, obviously, was the seminary reforms, which I was part of. Every reform we sort of suggested to George, he said, yes, that's going to happen. And he was very, very good with that. He had an ability to attract young people. You remember World Youth Day? Perhaps you're too young to remember this, but that was in 2008. And that was a massive event and a very good event. So he'll be remembered on many fronts. I think he's clearly a great ecclesial presence, George, and obviously was there for the election of a number of popes. And then I think this last appointment of his, obviously being, he was Archbishop of Melbourne and Archbishop of Sydney and did a lot of good things there, but the appointment as the prefect to the Secretary of the Economy to try and help really tighten up what happens financially in the Vatican was a very significant thing for him to do. And now he's gone to God, yeah. Mm.
Preparations are being made for his funeral. I just want to get your reaction that Victoria will not be offering him a state funeral.
Well, I don't know whether he's going to be buried down there because his last appointment was he was the Cardinal Archbishop of Sydney, so I would assume he'll be buried in Sydney. I don't have any inside running on.
He will be buried in Sydney. I suppose Victorian Premier Daniel Andrews was asked whether a state funeral may have been offered for George Pell, and Daniel Andrews has made it clear that he won't be doing that.
Oh, yes, yeah. Well, that's his decision, but what happens in Sydney, I suppose, is going to happen to be the prerogative of the Premier in Sydney, yeah.
Okay, Father Tony Percy, really appreciate your time today. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Gabriella. See you. Bye-bye.